Love in the time of tech. And it's not just about swiping left or swiping right, but giving women a safe place to make the first move, rewriting the rules of engagement, and addressing what some call the inequity in relationships, or at least in starting one. This company has gone from a startup to a unicorn to its CEO and founder becoming the youngest woman to take a company public in the U.S. Bumble's Lucille McCart joins us this morning. Lucille, you join us for some insights on the dating trends this 2024. Thank you for joining us on this day, special day.
Thank you so much for having me, and happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day. You know, Lucille, I want to start in a playful way, and I want to say so much has changed since I personally got off the dating market. I've got a list of some lingos, love lingos, and maybe I could ask you if you might be familiar with them or if you might know what they are. Let's start with this, ghosting.
Ghosting. So ghosting is when you poof and disappear like a ghost and you just cut off all contact with someone. It's very bad behavior and we don't condone it on Bumble.
All right. And what about breadcrumbing?
Breadcrumbing is almost ghosting, but you don't quite disappear. You leave a few little breadcrumbs to make the person think that you might be coming back or they're not quite sure. You don't completely ghost, but you almost do.
Wow, you're very good with the love lingos of this generation. What about beige flag? This is the first time I'm hearing it.
Okay, so a beige flag. So a red flag is a no-go zone. You know, that's a sign that that person is not going to be compatible or a good partner. So it might be really obvious things like, you know, anger management problems or things like that. And a green flag is a sign that they're a really good person, that they're kind, that they're fun, that they're going to be compatible with you. A beige flag is a sign that they might just be a bit boring.
Yeah, it's being used to describe romantic partners' weird habits that are less than a deal breaker, but not exactly a plus. Sounds right.
Yeah, exactly.
What about cuffing?
So cuffing isn't quite as big a trend in sort of Southeast Asia as what it is in Europe and North America, but it's that feeling when, as the winter season sets in, you might want to cuff or settle down with someone for those sort of cooler months. So you might find a temporary partner to get you through the winter.
Uh-huh.
And we see that a little bit in our part of the world, but we're lucky to be blessed with warmer climates, so we don't need that much.
Wow, you are a relationship guru. Finally, love bombing.
Love bombing. So that is when someone sort of like drops their love on you like a bomb. You know, they come on very strong in the early days. They're really hitting you hard with the compliments and the, you know, really making you feel like a certain way very quickly. And while it can feel very nice at the time, it can be a sign that they are, you know, coming on too strong too soon. So it's a behavior to look out for because it can be a sign that maybe you are being sort of manipulated in a certain way. So it's about trusting your instinct of, is this too much too soon, or is this person actually the love of my life?
Amazing. That's 5 out of 5. You're certainly a love guru. So I wonder, you know, are any of these emerging from your most recent survey done by Bumble? I know that you did a survey. I'm curious, did you see some of these trends that we talked about? And maybe if you could share with us, what did you find out about Filipinos in love and possibly dating?
Well, my favorite thing about Filipinos is that they love love. Filipinos are very romantic. They're very excited about relationships. You know, that's very ingrained in Filipino culture. And I think that's why Bumble has been so successful in the Philippines. And we do see things, you know, like ghosting is a behavior that people really reject because it's disrespectful and it's bad manners, right? And I think, you know, it's something we really try and encourage people on Bumble to, instead of ghosting, just be better communicators. You know, not everyone is going to work out for you. And there are kind and respectful ways to let people down or transition to a friendship instead of a romantic connection. And we try and give people those tools. But with the Philippines in particular, a trend that we're seeing for 2024 is called consider dating. And that's really about Filipino women, especially wanting to take things slow and be really careful about how they spend their energy on dating. So it might be about, you know, talking in the app for longer, going on dates and progressing the relationship a bit slower to make sure that you really are compatible with someone and you're focusing on emotional intimacy, not just that sort of physical attraction.
Mm-hmm. So what else did you find out about Filipino women, even men, on the app?
Well, they're also responding well to this trend called betterment burnout. And betterment burnout is us feeling a little bit burnt out from the pressure to be sort of on the self-improvement train all the time. You know, people want to be, exercising more and setting New Year's resolutions to, read more books, do all of these things. And this trend is really about saying, I actually am going to take a step back from all of these self-improvement goals and try and find someone who likes me for me as I am now. And I think that's a really healthy trend because, it encourages us to find relationships with people that are happy with us, as our authentic selves.
Mm-hmm. And what about timeline decline? Women, and many, many women feel this. There is a timeline. You're 35, 36, and you're not married or you're not even dating. People wonder what's wrong. There must
you
be something wrong with
questions.
You. And women feel pressured. When they hit a certain age, that they have to be dating, that they have to have someone. Is the pressure as strong today as it was before? Or are women starting to evolve?
I think the pressure is still there. And I think it's not just for single people. It's when you start dating someone, is it getting more serious? Are you going to get engaged? Are you going to get married? Are you going to have children? All of these sort of questions. The pressure is definitely still there. But what women are sort of saying now more than ever is, I don't want to have to respond to this pressure. And I want to be able to set my own timeline and do things at my own pace. And so we're seeing women getting much better at sort of setting those boundaries with their friends and family and saying, I'm in charge of when I make these big moves in my life.
Mm-hmm. I'm going over the survey results. 1 in 3 Filipino women say they're no longer focused on adhering to traditional timelines and milestones, reflected in intentions with nearly 3 in 4 Filipino women looking for a long-term relationship and less than 1/3 seeking marriage. Times have changed.
Isn't it? I know. And I think that doesn't necessarily mean that people don't want to get married, but I think it means it's not their sort of primary goal. Mm-hmm. And that is a really healthy thing in one respect, because it means that people are prioritizing the relationship being really good and really strong and healthy and equal and all of those things that we value at Bumble. Mm-hmm. And if it ends up in a marriage, that is, great. That's fantastic. But it's not necessarily people's number one goal.
And there's such a thing as a generational blend romance?
There is, yes. That's people being more open-minded to dating someone a few years older or a few years younger than them. And I think it's really exciting that, Filipinos are being more open-minded around this, because age really is just a number. And it doesn't mean that, as women, we might be able to fall in love with someone a few years younger than us. I think there was always a bit of a stigma around that, but it's changing. People's maturity levels are so individual, and we can really be compatible with anyone, really. And so I think, generation blend is about just being a bit more open-minded in who our options are within the dating pool.
Mm-hmm. Lucille, the founder of Bumble, in one of her interviews a couple of years ago, she actually clarified that Bumble is not exactly a dating app like Tinder, which she also co-founded. It's more a relationship app. I wanted to ask you, relationships. So it's not just about love, right? You have Bumble BFF, where you can make friends as well on the app. How does it work? Just for those who are not too familiar, could you walk us through how different Bumble is from the other dating apps out there and how big you are in Asia Pac and in the Philippines in particular? How many eyeballs are we talking about?
Yeah, Philippines is one of our fastest growing markets. That's really exciting to see. But we do, as you said, see ourselves as a relationship company. And in the future, being able to facilitate, all types of connections. At the moment, you can use the Bumble app for romantic dating. You can also download an app called Bumble for Friends, which is all about platonic friend finding. And so on there, you can download the app and you can meet, like, I can meet other women that are interested in platonic friendship because, you know, it really developed from this insight of we're seeing, especially post pandemic, this worldwide loneliness epidemic. People are really craving social connections that aren't just romantic. You know, why should the dating app landscape just be limited to romantic connections when your platonic friendships and your personal connections are just as, if not more important than, you know, the one person that you're in a romantic relationship with? To have a happy and healthy life takes multiple connections, not just romantic. It takes family, it takes friends, it takes work colleagues. You know, we also have an app called Bumble Biz, which is about helping to facilitate professional connections and find mentors and mentorees. And so, yeah, we really see ourselves as a company that is able to facilitate romantic, platonic, and business connections because all of those are so fundamental to the human experience.
And how big are you in the Philippines? You did say that we're one of the fastest growing. Are we the country that uses Bumble the most?
One of in Southeast Asia, yes, and growing really quickly. You know, our markets in Southeast Asia and APAC in general that we see a lot of activity in are countries like India, Singapore, Philippines, and Australia and New Zealand as well as, you know, markets like European markets and North America.
So, which country actually uses Bumble the most? I'm curious.
Well, that's a stiff competition, isn't it? But in Southeast Asia, it would probably be the Philippines.
Ah, it's the Philippines. All right, all right. I also wanted to go to the business side of things. We do know that the relationship of dating apps with investors have been pretty shaky in the last couple of years. I mean, on the rocks. Bloomberg described it as, you know, a relationship with investors on the rocks for online dating stocks. Mostly been ghosted by last year's scorching tech rally. How is the, and I know that you're in the quiet period now for the earnings season because you are listed. But if you could just give us a general sense of this industry, of the sector, how tough is competition? You know, are you having a harder time to getting people to subscribe and pay a certain amount for these connections and to keeping them?
Yeah, I would say it's not really for me to comment on some of those questions, but what I would say is that when you look at the success of apps like Bumble, I would point to the thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of relationships, marriages, engagements, Bumble babies, Bumble pets that have been, you know, the result of our business all over the world and in the Philippines. And, you know, that's what we're really focused on, is helping people find those meaningful connections that will make.
Yeah, I think we lost our connection with Lucille. We'll try to get her back.